What's up? Today, we're just gonna be, I don't know. I just don't know. Do you ever have one of those days where you're just like, you know, I probably ought to figure out what the heck I'm gonna do today? And then you go out to your garage and it's just one heck of a mess. I mean, so you got so much done last week and you were plumb tuckered at the end of the day, so you just went inside. And then you came back outside and you're like, holy crap, I ain't working in that pigsty. So you go grab yourself a beer and then sit down and, well, you don't do anything. Well, today I'm gonna cure that itch or whatever. I gotta clean this garage here, all right? I gotta clean the fab lab. So today I'm going to be organizing some stuff, getting some of my mess just cleaned up. So it ain't going to be much of a video today. I got some big things that I got to, I'm taking the transmission to the transmission shop this week. So we're going to have a big deal there. One thing we are going to do today. I think we're going to take the wiring harness off the old LS there and kind of get it ready, get the motor and the mock-up transmission bolted together just so I can, once I get this frame cleaned up, we can flip her over and mock up the engine mounts and stuff. But I'm going to put y'all on a tripod here and you're just going to watch me clean up my shop. And then we'll work on the old LS. So, stay tuned. Howdy, y'all. Welcome to the Mayhem's Fab Lab channel. So, I'm going to flip y'all around here, show you what I've already done to the shop. I had to real quick do something so I could get my trailer out of the garage because we had a storm last night and I needed to get my truck in. I don't like having my truck outside. So, flip you around here. All right, I got the axles here, the new jobbies. That's cool. This right here, that's my AC condenser. I had to move some stuff around and forgot that I put that there. Whoops. And as you can see here, there's a little bit of rearranging done here. Whoops. There we go. We got the Jeep. We pushed it out the garage door there so I can have more fabbing room because I'm not going to be doing much to the Jeep for at least a little bit. So, what I'm going to do now is try to clean up this stuff in here. And this chair is like, I don't know why it's there. Yeah, and then I'll give y'all a big viz on the old workbench. It's yucky. I use it as a catch-all, which is probably the worst thing you can do there. But I'll get that all cleaned up, get my toolbox organized again, so that next week we can actually make some dang progress. Last weekend I was out of town, so I didn't really get much done. I mean, y'all saw the video from last week, but I didn't really get much done until the middle of this week. Today's Friday, so, well, geez, it's not even the middle of this week. Today's my first day back in the garage, so... flip y'all around and we'll get to cleaning up this lab. You know what I'm saying? When I took the axles off of the trailer, I opened up some of those boxes that I said, "Oh, well, I don't really know what's in those boxes, but yeah, that's probably them things there and them things there." Well, I opened up these boxes. I'll show you what all I got in here. All right. Here, I believe these are Rough Stuff covers. Got two of them. Got an extra RCV boot. I got, I guess, a single lube blocker. Let's see, that is a. That looks like the bolts for the Rough Stuff diff covers, and then here's another one. Yep. And then I got these doomajiggies. Now, the issue with these, let me see if I can't show you here. With the sleeves in place, they don't fit. So, I guess I'll be selling these puppies because I don't need them. Well, I need them, but I don't can't fit them. So, there's that. And in here we have, that was the RCV boot that I just showed you. We got more RCV boots. So I should be set on RCV boots. And then those in there are the front brake calipers. So, if you happen to be curious what was in the boxes, yeah, that's what's in the boxes. So, I'm gonna bring y'all over to the workbench and show you what kind of a pigsty that place is. Dear Lord, it's gross. But we'll get her cleaned up and get her organized, and yeah, then we'll maybe start working on the old LS. All right. Just look at the pigsty that is my workbench. I almost called it my desk. I guess it is kind of a desk sometimes, but yeah, got some cleaning up to do. But put you all on a stand and get this thing here cleaned up real quick. I know you're not supposed to reuse these, but it's still better than that. I mean, there's still some life in this one just for grinding and junk. So I'm gonna keep reusing this one. Sorry if you don't like that. Not sorry. I'd like to pause for a brief moment and introduce to you one of the greatest items I have found for use in the Fab Lab. It is none other than a stick of anti-seize. Seriously, though. This is one I found at the local Ace Hardware, but Loctite Company makes a, like, literally, it's like a glue stick of anti-seize. So, and you just roll your bolt in it, screw it in, good to go. It's unlike that big canister of goop that when you take one slide out, you look like the Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz, like that. Yeah. This, or something like this, so this little magic stick. Money. You don't get so stinking dirty. So, pro tip for the day, if you don't want to be looking like the Tin Man after using anti-seize. Get one of these sticks or a glue stick from Loctite. I think I haven't found them at AutoZone or Advance or whatever. That's where I think I got it the first time. But check them out on like Amazon or whatever. I'll just drop a link for the actual glue stick on Amazon. Yeah, that'll be in the cart there. So on with the show. Well, now we got the shop relatively cleaned up. I mean, it ain't perfect, but whole heck of a lot better than it was. So, now we're going to do what I think most of y'all have been waiting for. And that's, we're going to, well, if you're continuing to watch this video, this is probably what you're waiting for. We're going to start bring the old Lus motor out here. And we're going to... I'm gonna get out my marker and the some painter's tape, start marking some stuff, and taking that wiring harness off so that I can bring it over to my uncle's house, or he can come over here, and we can set it out on a workbench and get that thing cleaned up where there's all the unnecessary junk is out of here. So, I'm going to put y'all at the other end of the garage, roll the old motor out, and then set y'all up on a pod. My dang shoe! Well, this thing seems to have a never-ending supply of coolant in it. Spilled it all over the floor again. Anyways, I'm gonna got painter's tape here, and some sort of marker. I'm gonna just start marking and unplugging. You'd think I never worked on a motor before. Please pause a brief moment. Please pause a brief moment while I go on the YouTubes.
2 hours later.
All right, I'm gonna take these coil brackets off because they seem to be in my way. What am I missing? Let's see if the oil's ever been vacuumed. Doesn't look terrible. Cool. Now, I just gotta figure out how to get these darn tootin' things out. I don't get it. Oh, well, ladies and gentlemen, got this one off, which what I had to do was pull this blue thing out, basically like that, and then the old trigger worked. But that front one is still giving me a little bit of grief. Zoo Pete. Nothing should be that hard. I'm about tired of this. Idle air control valve. That's what I'm gonna put. All right, well, that's gonna be it for today. I'll probably be back tomorrow and finish taking this wiring harness off and all that. But for right now, I gotta go, it's date night. So, I gotta go clean up just a skosh and then we're gonna go on, my wife and I are gonna go out car shopping. So, I will see y'all tomorrow.
Welcome back. It's a beautiful morning here in Pennsylvania. It's pretty cold. But, you like this, guys? Check it out, man. Check that out. She's seen some use. But, it's my favorite jacket. It's nice and warm. And I got my 100% red blood American hat going on here. Today we're going to finish up taking off the wiring here off the old LIS motor. And I think that'll pretty much wrap up this episode of Mayhem's Fab Lab. Next week I think we're going to pick up the old blank 4L60. Well, not blank, but it's she's completely gutted. So, pretty light. And bolted up to this thing. Flip the old frame over. Start mocking up placement and all that stuff. So, you'll have to wait till next week for that, though. In the meantime, let's get to hoofing on this thing. Maybe he went golfing. I don't know. Ta-da! There it is. She's got all the wiring out of it. Now we gotta figure out what we're gonna do with all this junk. Or gold. I don't know. Alright. Well, that's gonna end off today's video. Today, we got the wiring harness off the old LIS motor. And we first we cleaned up the garage and we got the wiring harness off. And so just a reminder, next week we're gonna be taking, well, I'm taking the transmission out. Next week we should be hooking up our mock-up transmission up to the old LIS motor. and putting it, flipping the old frame over, putting the motor mounts, you know, roughly where they should be, mocking everything up. So should be pretty fun. Remember to like, subscribe, comment, YouTube-y stuff. And yeah, we'll catch y'all next week. Bye-bye.